Excellent as usual, Mother. The roast beef was done to perfection.
Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. At least one of my boys has enough to eat. And with the Confederate Army practically at our back door, it may be the last we'll get for a while.
Mother, there's nothing to worry about. Our army is bigger than theirs, and we'll drive the rebels right into the Potomac. I hear that ragtag army is practically starving anyhow, which is just what they deserve.
Isabel, please. Try to remember that your brother-in-law is married to a Southern girl and that she is part of this family.
Of course, Mother. I don't know why we're talking about the war anyway. I wanted to discuss the ball with you.
I thought it was to be a reception, Isabel. A dress ball would be in very poor taste during times like these.
Mother, Hazard Iron is doing better than ever before. Money is pouring in. Why shouldn't we entertain our friends and business associates?
Oh, these new friends and associates of yours, they are people we know nothing about, except that they seem to be making a great deal of money.
Business is thriving because of the war, Mother. Everyone knows that. Stanley and I have done business with them, some of whom are quite influential in New York and Washington.
Where money makes all the difference. Now it will be a modest reception, or it will not be held at all.
Very well. I can still wear my emeralds.
I don't mean to keep harping on this, but it was very, very extravagant of Stanley to buy those for you.
They were Stanley's way of saying thank you for all the advice that I have given him in business matters. Because of me, Hazard Iron has more orders than it's ever had. Isn't that right, my darling?
Well, if you'll excuse me, I have some committee reports to read.
The War Department has begun to prosecute those making excessive profits. If there is an investigation...
There will be no investigation of Hazard Iron. We have nothing to worry about.
How can you say that? We sold inferior cannons to the army.
Axel Iron sold those cannons.
If the war contract with Axel is ever connected to Hazard Iron, everybody knows that I've been running that company.
Before the war, you had to have George's approval on every decision. Most people will assume that's still true. And to make sure, I took out some insurance for us.
Insurance? I don't understand.
I forged George's name on all the contracts to make it appear as though he signed them before he left for the army.
That makes him legally responsible.
Exactly. So, if the government investigates, which they won't, they'll prosecute George instead of us. Haven't I been right about everything else?
Yankees will learn how to fight.
Looks like our boys could use a hand, Ambrose.
Thank you. meet you up on the ridge. Report to a mayor.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Came to say goodbye, Ambrose. This wasn't a day for heroes, pal.
The bloodiest day of the war. Nearly 25,000 killed, wounded, or missing at Antietam Creek. And more than half of them ours.
I wouldn't have thought it possible, Mr. President.
That we could slaughter each other on such a scale. Dear God. The poor families of the dead. McClellan calls it a masterpiece.
At least Lee has pulled out and is retreating back to Virginia.
I promised myself that as soon as we drove them out of Maryland, I'd call it a victory and issue the proclamation.
To free the slaves in the South.
It's always been the right thing to do. But, George, I still need a hell for leather general. We can't go on this way, savaging each other to make more widows and orphans. Your report makes Ulysses Grant sound likely.
Yes, sir. I know him well. He was 2 years ahead of me at West Point.
You told Buckner at Fort Donelson that he'd accept no terms but unconditional surrender. When I heard that, I knew I'd found a man I could talk to.
There will be opposition to him if you choose him, sir.
Because he drinks?
I don't believe it. But he was rumored to have been drunk at Shiloh.
Yet he carried the day. George, I'm gonna watch him. Grant may be the commander I need, a man who can exploit the Confederacy's weaknesses and force them to the wall. There's a whole way of life at stake here. If it's God's will that we prevail, we won't just win a war. We'll secure freedom for all our people.
General Grant.
Hey, tell me you're from Washington, Colonel. I'm tired of them hounding me. If I see fit to keep my soldiers warm by issuing 2 pairs of long johns, that's nobody's business but mine or theirs.
Yes, sir. I'm not from the Inspector General's office. President Lincoln asked that I speak to you privately, sir.
President sent you, huh?
Yes, sir.
What's your name?
Hazard. George Hazard.
Well, sit down.
Thank you, sir.
So I know you, Colonel?
Yes, sir. We go back to West Point. I was in my second year when you graduated.
Of course. I remember now. You had a darn fine record at the point.
Thank you, sir.
A lot of fine officers came out of that class. It's a shame we're fighting each other now. Not all of us will live to see the end of it, either.
That's why I'm here, sir. The president thinks that you're the man to end the war sooner by winning it.
Needs an admiral, not a general. Only our control of the Mississippi will shorten this war by cutting the enemy off from the west.
He doesn't want an admiral, sir. He wants a general like Robert E. Lee.
I don't blame him. Lee's the best soldier on either side. I often wonder if he remembers me from Mexico.
Well, I'm sure he knows your name now, sir.
Excuse me, Colonel. I forgot to offer you some of this. Go ahead.
Thank you, sir.
apple cider, sir.
You know, I'm not near the drinker some people would like to believe.
Well, maybe you should know that those rumors have reached the ear of the president. He replied that he'd like to know what kind of whiskey you drank, so he could buy some for his other generals.
He said that, did he?
Yes, sir.
Tell the president. You tell him that if he so chooses. I'll fight Lee for him. Can't promise him an easy victory, but I'll fight him.
I'm sure he'll be glad to hear that, sir. General Grant, if you do take over, I have been wanting a field command for a long time, sir. I would be honored to serve under you.
Well, I'd be honored to have you, Colonel.
Thank you, sir.
That on the first day of January in the year of our Lord, 1863, all persons held as slaves within any state or designated part of a state, the people whereof shall then be in rebellion against the United States, shall be then thenceforward and forever free. And the executive government of the United States, including the military and naval authorities thereof, will recognize and maintain the freedom of such persons. And I hereby enjoin upon the people so declared to be free to abstain from all violence unless in necessary self-defense. And I recommend to them that in all cases when allowed, they labor faithfully for reasonable wages. Upon this act, sincerely believed to be an act of justice, warranted by the Constitution upon military necessity, I invoke the considerate judgment of mankind and the gracious favor of Almighty God.
You might be needing your old overseer in these troubled times. Congratulations, Mrs. Main. I understand you married the general.
What have you done? Dear God.
It's Jim!
You killed him.
Well, I run him to earth, but he tried to grab my gun when I was bringing him back to you. So I had to shoot him.
How could you? He was just a boy.
Bullet's got a mind of its own, ma'am. Maybe what happens all for the best.
You're not welcome here. My son, Ori, wanted no part of you. Nor do we.
You may change your tune, Miss Clarissa, when you realize how much y'all gonna be needing me. A few slaves around Charleston run away when they grapevine told them about that devil Lincoln's proclamation. Let them see what we still do to fugitives in the South. All I ask is a small interest in this plantation. You won't have to worry about runaways, I can promise you. I can get more work out of these slaves.
Apparently you didn't hear my mother. Get off our land.
Oh, my God. Jim! You murderer! You murderer!
No!
You
murderer! Let me go.
No! I ain't gonna let you get yourself killed.
You get out of here before I take my own gun to you.
You'd side with an uppity wench? Another year of this war and you Maines may not be so high and mighty. Lots of changes gonna be made around here.
Jim was like Sam Ramus's younger brother. cared about him so much.
The other slave owners have nothing but scorn for Mr. Lincoln's proclamation. They say he has no authority here. But if another Jim wants his freedom, we can't stop him.
We have to keep this plantation going. It's all we have.
I don't want to see such a dreadful thing ever happen again.
If they decide to leave, then the only hope we have to protect them is to give them passes and let them go.
That poor boy. I can't believe what's happening.
Mama? I think Madeline and I should pay our respects to Jim's family.
We'll make it through this time.
Miss Bird, Miss Madeline, y'all come in, please.
We wanted to pay our respects to James' family.
We are deeply sorry, Liza. We know what a comfort and joy he was to you. If there's anything we can do, pray for him.
We will. And we thought you ought to know that we want you to stay with us because we need you. But if anyone wants to leave us, please come to us, tell us. And we can give you papers that might stop another Salem Jones from doing what he did to our James. That's all we wanted to say.
I'd got long.
Steal away.
think what I think. Those black psalm singers in there, that blood half as hot as mine. We could march right on up to that old house and make it our own. But they ain't. They gonna go right on. Yes, massa. No, massa. Till the day they's laid out on that table like that damn fool boy in there.
He wasn't no fool. He had a dream.
He was a fool. A fool that learns a few words in the Bible and thought he could go to freedom armed with the Lord's might. This is the only might that the white man understands. Cold steel. You ready to go with me, gal? We'll take a little midnight walk. Join our kind over at the Union Base at Hilton Head.
I ain't gonna walk with you.
Don't you hear what I'm saying to you, gal? I'm offering you your freedom if you come with me.
I ain't gonna...
Some people don't know when they ain't want it. Why don't you just march yourself right on out of here?
Don't go, Ezra.
You want something, boy?
No! Ain't there been enough killing? Cuffy, I wouldn't walk with you if heaven was a-waiting over the next hill.
You stay there. Keep waiting for your white rooster, Charles, who's all fighting to keep me and you slaves. Maybe he'll let you sleep in his bed. Ain't nothing left here for me. Except maybe pay for all the pain, sweat, and blood these folks done took from me.
I'm glad you come out, Ezra.
I see him follow you.
I don't know how I'm gonna go back in that house tonight. Maybe I just ought to light out.
Been thinking about that myself. Only trouble is, I want to share that new life with someone.
Ezra.
You were so close to freedom when you was in Washington. Why you come back?
I got the note about Miss Clarissa.
Or is it what Cuffy say? Where you feel about Mr. Charles?
I just come back because I come back, that's all. And I'm gonna stay. For now.
That it, ain't it? Mr. Charles. I wouldn't have thought you'd even be able to think of a white man after Salem Jones.
Don't ever say that man name to me again. Now, I just want to be alone.
I'm sorry, Simi. I don't want you to hurt no more. That all?
Thank you.
has a lot of hungry soldiers to feed. No Shenandoah farmers sure do their part. I can see why they call this the breadbasket of the Confederacy. Major Dupre, you'd be commended on the way you've kept these supply trains on schedule.
Well, it's all your blueprint, General. All we had to do is carry it out.
Well, I best get back in the saddle if I'm gonna make it to Tennessee by late tomorrow. Once again, thank you for your dedication.
Thank you, sir. Now, we all appreciate what you're doing for the whole Army, General Meade. You have a safe journey now. Gentlemen.
Those Hooker's men?
Yes, sir. They've been laying low for us all over this part of Virginia. Sure glad you came back, General. We'll be losing your light in about an hour. Why don't you and your aides stay the night with us?
Thank you, Major. I might just do that.
You a married man, General?
Yes. Recently, as a matter of fact.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Where's your wife?
South Carolina with my family.
Well, my Brenda is in Tennessee. It's a little town near Shelbyville. I haven't seen him about 2 years now. I got a little girl that I ain't ever seen, General. Sometimes I wonder if I ever will.
You will, Josh. We all will.
Well, I guess that depends on General Lee now, doesn't it? You really think he's gonna be able to march into Pennsylvania?
He wants to drive east and try to cut off Washington. We need a major victory in the North, and Lee knows it. Trouble is, Hooker's army has him shattered into Maryland. Now Hooker's been replaced by Meade, and Meade's a much better soldier.
Looks like Lee's got his work cut out for him.
We all have, Major.
Sir, you say you're gonna be traveling through Tennessee? Might you drop off some letters to my Brenda? I wrote 5 of them. But you know how hard it is to get the mail through, sir.
Sure. Be my pleasure.
Thank you, General. Sleep well, sir.
You too. Good night.
Good night.
Caleb. What is this? Where are you going?
Miss Brett said we could go if we want to. We're leaving, Mr. Ory.
But this is your home.
No, sir. This was never our home.
I feel poorly, Miss Clarissa, ma'am, about leaving like this and all. But leastwise, you won't have all these mouths to feed.
What will you do in Charleston?
Oh, there should be some work there now, ma'am. All the men folk gone soldiering and all. I should be able to find something.
Well, until you do, you need this to buy food for the children.
Oh, Miss Clarissa, you don't have to do this, ma'am. You hardly have enough as it is.
We'll be fine.
Thank you, ma'am.
God be with you, Joseph.
I'll never forget my role, ma'am. Goodbye. Take care of yourself.
We'll miss y'all.
I know what you're feeling, Ory.
But why?
We couldn't keep him against their will with so many of them running off.
I just can't believe it, even Joseph.
There's a chill in the air tonight.
A few days ago, I dropped off some letters for this major's family. He hadn't seen nor heard from them in over a year. This war isn't what we expected. It's just too much sacrifice. It's changing us all.
I do know what a hurtful day you've had.
I have been blind, Madeline, expecting everything to stay the same. You've all had to face so much more than I ever imagined. And you and Brett out in the fields, like, and Mom up.
Underneath that southern gentility, your mother is a very strong woman.
Her world has fallen apart almost overnight. And that look in her eye,
Ory, she does have a right to a little sadness.
Wish it would stop.
You are the gentlest man I've ever known. And the strongest. Our family will survive because of the strength we give one another. Don't let go. Don't let go.
Thank you.
That's my dearest memory of you, Mama. You smile.
Oh, Ori, I was just thinking about you. What a rascal you were when you were little. Forever in the swamps, hunting snakes with Joseph. Until your father made you understand that a son who was going to inherit the finest plantation in these parts must behave like a gentleman. Mont Royal, the way I remember.
It's beautiful. What you used to do to put me to sleep. You were always there with that smile that said, Ori Main, you're destined to be my pride and joy, and if I'm wrong and you turn out to be a no account, I'll love you anyway.
Got to hold Lee here at Round Top. I want you to take positions behind those boulders and slow their advancing skirmishers when the rebels come up that hill first thing in the morning.
Attention, company!
At ease, men. Any more coffee, Lieutenant?
Yes, sir.
George? My God, what are you doing here?
Oh, damn, I'm glad to see you.
Good to see you, little brother. Come on up to my campfire.
How are your boys holding out?
Heard the Rebs gave us quite a licking today.
Tap shoes are doing all right. How's the family?
Oh, they're fine. Our little daughter, Hope, just celebrated another birthday.
I heard about your promotion to General Staff of Third Corps.
Yes. Well, the President finally interceded. So I can let somebody else worry about the lobbyists and profiteers for a change.
After you've been out here a while, you might decide Washington isn't so bad.
It's been so frustrating watching our boys be pushed around the map for so long. I'd like to think I'm a bigger help to Sam Grant by being out here in the field. Oh, we have missed you.
Have you heard from Brett?
Billy, it's hard enough getting mail through from the north, much less the south. Whenever Constance and I are separated...
George, I haven't seen Brett in 2 years.
Nobody thought the war would last this long. I know it'll work out. Just hold on and do the best you can.
Thank you.
am now ready to be offered. And the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith.
Right shoulder, Chef!
Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness. Forward.
I will be back.
He's whipped. General Meade has to do is stop him from crossing the Potomac.
Lee will find a way to keep this damn war going. He'll lick his wounds and be back at us in a couple of months. Rudy, I can't stand the thought that I might never see Brett again. Before anything happens to me, I've got to make sure she's all right.
You're not thinking.
I'm not thinking. I've decided.
Billy, it's desertion.
Absence without leave. Before there's another battle, I'll be back. Make sure and tell Tom that.
Felt his troops were exhausted, sir.
He had reinforcements the next day. Lee had none.
The torrential rain made it difficult for the general.
And impossible for Lee. He had his back to the Potomac. He was trapped. He was unable to get his army back to Virginia.
Again, we had him in our grasp. We had only to reach out our hands, and they were ours. But nothing, nothing I could say or do would make General Meade move. That, by God, that's all I want to hear today about the Army of the Potomac. The victory at Gettysburg seems so hollow now. God knows, I never wanted this conflict. But I have sounded the trumpet, and I can never call retreat. We must endure the
this fiery trial. It must go on.
Freeze! Right where you are, son. I'd hate to have to blow your brains out. Now slide that gun over here now. Do it, boy! You're a dead man! Mighty far south for a Yankee, aren't you? Maybe you just got tired of the army, huh? Like I did. Sure is a piece of luck for me, though, huh? Running into you. I told the Lord I could sure use a horse. And some new boots. And looky here how he's provided. Now, you'll be a good boy when you take off them boots nice and slow. I might not kill you. Go ahead. You're brand new, ain't it?
Raymond. Twenty-third South Carolina Infantry.
Sure, that's not too heavy.
No, it's fine.
Glass of water. Oh, Mother, you don't have to do that. Why don't you just work on your needlepoint? Mother, what's wrong?
If you're gonna work in the fields, least I can do is to keep this house. Why, as time goes on, Madeline's gonna need this smock in her condition.
I know, but I think you're trying to do more than you should.
I am not an old woman. I can do my share.
Mother, nobody...
You don't have to say. I can tell by the way you all look at me.
Mother, if it's the other day...
It's every day. You treat me like China to protect me from the war. This county has suffered terrible losses at Gettysburg. Some of those boys were family, friends. And you never told me.
We would have. We just didn't want to upset you.
I have a right to know. If anything ever happens to Ori, Charles, or Billy, I need to know. And I want you girls to come to me with your problems like you used to. Because I do needlepoint doesn't mean that's all I care about is the best.
Mother, I'm sorry.
Oh, those were wonderful years, child. You're growing up. I wish with all my heart he could be that way again. But I know now those times are gone. Forever. He can steal our food. The army can strip our barn. Our people can all leave. And you girls can go and live lives of your own. But nobody, nobody's gonna take away my memories.
Worked all morning to get these. There ain't hardly enough for dinner.
Well, you can't make it rain.
Maybe we can put in another crop near the river.
I don't know, the growing season might last long enough to make it worthwhile.
If we plant close enough to the riverbank, maybe we can guess some way to get enough water to get to the seeds and make them strong until they can stand the sun.
It's a wonderful idea. We should try it. Now we have to go to the cotton field.
No. You've done enough for one day.
Miss Marlin shouldn't go back out there no more.
I'm fine. The baby isn't due for months. I can still work hard. I agree with Semiramis. Why, in my day, ladies rested most of the time. Waited on hand and foot.
Mother, I can do it with...
Oh, I know. My day is over. But that won't stop my feeling of joy at a new generation being born at Mont Royal.
People could afford carriages like that anymore.
Hello, Mother.
Ashton.
You'd come home.
Ashton.
Hello, Madeline, dear.
Hello, Ashton.
Mother, I brought gifts for everyone. Some real coffee for you and the biggest ham you ever saw.
And Brett, I brought you material for a new dress. Looks like you could use it.
In fact, the whole place looks pretty run down.
We'll be back from the fields before sundown, Mother.
Fields? Well, what are you talking about?
We were able to plant 2 acres of cotton this year. Somebody has to weed it.
Well, of course they do. And that's why we have slaves.
No, we don't. They heard about Lincoln's proclamation and they left. We do the work now.
Mother, I want you to see my new dress.
Can you believe Abe Lincoln put darkies in the army? James says it would be a disgrace to be wounded by one, let alone killed by one.
How would James know? He's not fighting.
Semiramis, would you like some of my delectable ham?
No, thank you, ma'am. Isn't there any pleasant news from Richmond?
I'm afraid not, Mother. All everybody talks about is getting revenge for Gettysburg and retaking Vicksburg.
Why, they say we'll kill 10 Yankees for every one of ours. Mother, if everyone's finished, I'll clear the table.
Thank you, Brett, dear. I'm a little tired. I'll rest for a while and see you all in the parlor later.
Let me help you with these glasses, Semiramis.
I can do it myself, Miss Ashton.
You work much too hard. I do what has to be done. I know that we've had our differences, but we do have one thing in common.
We both care a great deal about this family.
What do you mean?
Well, you like Miss Madeline, don't you?
Well, she's a kind person.
Then you can help her. Maybe you can answer some questions for me. Who is it?
Madeline.
Ashton, I need to talk to you.
Why, Madeline, I couldn't sleep because I needed to talk to you, too.
How could you have done that to Semiramis?
Well, whatever do you mean? I've been as sweet as sugar to that darky.
She came to me. She is so upset about your persistent snooping.
All I wanted to ask about was what the slaves talked about down at the quarter before they left. And I understand that their grapevine has already picked up rumors and gossip that started from quality white people.
What are you trying to say, Ashton?
It came to me like a bolt out of the blue from a man in Richmond. Well, naturally, I wanted to come here and see if the story had reached Charleston yet.
What story?
I have some rather distressing news, Madeline. Your mother was part Negro. I know that you've probably told Ori, and no doubt he said that our family...
What is between Ori and me is none of your business, Ashton.
But I'm sure he doesn't know the whole truth. Maybe even you don't know the whole truth. Your mother sold herself to men for money.
You're lying.
This awful man actually had a portrait of her that looked exactly like you, so there's no doubt about it. It hung in a house of ill repute in New Orleans, where your mother, she...
But that was before your dad.
I don't want to hear any more. But I don't blame you, Madeline. It must be so upsetting to know what your mother was.
Yes, it is, Ashton.
Now, what worries me is mother. I think a family scandal would just...
Ashton! I love your mother. I love this family. If I thought one...
There's still time, Madeline. Now, it's bound to come out sooner or later. I know that you and Ori wanted a baby, but you never really thought of how that would affect our family if that baby turned out to be, well, let's just say, different. Now, if you were no longer Ori Main's wife, then you couldn't ruin your baby's future or disgrace our family. Now, could you, Madeline?
You must hate very much, Ashton.
Yes, I do hate you very much, Madeline. Now, Cana Bent was right. Hatred is like wine. It improves with age.
My love. The easiest thing I ever did was to love you, and the hardest, to say goodbye. We can no longer be together. Please forgive me, my dearest Ori. I love you, Madeline.
You use me. I haven't the faintest idea what you're talking about, child.
Because of you, Miss Madeline left.
If I were you, I wouldn't repeat such a serious accusation, or you're liable to find yourself in big trouble. Oh, Madeline left this for Ori. Will you make sure that he gets it, please?
You open it?
Well, I thought maybe she'd leave a clue to where she's gone. After all, I do care about her.
You don't care about nobody but yourself. Since I was a little girl, I watched the way you treat people like they wasn't even human. Property to serve your every need.
Mr. Lincoln can sign all the proclamations he wants, but as far as I'm concerned, you will always be a slave. So I would watch my tongue if I were you, Missy.
Black or white, I despise your kind, especially the way you even treat your own family. You're gonna pay for what you've done. Someday, you're gonna know what it is to be alone. Leave.
See, Simmy!
You've done it, Ezra! You've done it! We're coming stretching!
We'll scoop up the water, dump it in that deep sluice, then the water come down.
I can see how smart it is.
Now, all we got to do is plow that meadow and get it ready for planting.
And the seeds, they're gonna live now, and we're gonna beat that sun because of you. You're gonna make a good farmer. You know how to do so many things. Oh, we gonna lose the light soon. I'm gonna go run and tell him about your water wheel.
Simmy? I just wanna say, I know how much Salem Jones hurt you.
I told you not to ever say that man's name to me again.
You got a devil in your soul. It's hurting real bad, Simmy. You gotta let him out. Stop running. Stop it, Simmy. Talk to me.
Sometimes I'll wake at night and I think he'd be there. What he did to me. I can't.
It's all right.
Just made me afraid to really love somebody.
Simmy.
Ezra, you're the kindest man I know, but I ain't sure that I'll ever be able to love. I'm sorry.
Simmy.
Ezra.
Over by that tree.
Mr. Billy.
Mr. Billy. Ezra. Good to see you. When you change side?
I'm just using the uniform long enough to stay alive.
Billy.
It's been a long time, Semiramis.
Miss Brett gonna be so happy to see you. But you best be careful. Miss Ashton's up at the house. And there's a Confederate camp down the road a piece. And she's real friendly with the Colonel.
I won't endanger the family.
But I'm not about to let Miss Ashton keep me from seeing my wife. Not after the hell I've been through.
Well, come on. We're gonna hide you.
It just doesn't make any sense. Something must have happened.
But why didn't Madeline come to us? No matter what it was, she knows how we care about her.
If she really cared about you, Mother, and your feelings, she wouldn't have left in the first place.
Ashton.
We were so happy together. So many have lost loved ones. Preston Wayne till his best friend. Now they're both gone. Prez's son was just lost at... Where was it, Brett?
Vicksburg, Mom.
With all these terrible battles, I've forgotten.
This is ridiculous, Mother. You shouldn't have to live under such dismal circumstances, constantly being reminded of things that are gone. James and I would love it if you came to live with us in Richmond.
Ashton, that's sweet of you.
You belong with people who can look after you properly. We have a lovely townhouse, and you'll be more than comfortable there until after the war.
But I just couldn't.
Oh, tell her, Brett. Surely you can see how much better it would be for her.
Ashton's right, Mama. You deserve better after all you've been through.
We can pack you a trunk and be off by the end of the week.
I'm still not so old that my daughters have to tell me where I should live.
Oh, Mother, please.
Oh, I know you mean well, my dear. But this is my home. This is where your father brought me as a young bride. You children were born in that room upstairs. It's not just memories. I could never leave. This house is my life.
Oh, pardon me, ma'am, for busting in like this. But I thought y'all want to know right away.
What is it, Semiramis?
Ezra Waterwheel. It worked! It worked!
That's wonderful. That's wonderful.
Brett, we can start on our new patch at first light.
All right.
I need you to show me the seed corn.
Oh, I'll only be a moment, Mother.
Seed corn? Oh, Mother, I do wish you'd reconsider.
I used to come out here. I used to play on this dock. It's so beautiful. But as much as I love Mont Royal, there was always something missing. Really, don't go back.
Tom would get me by the scruff of the neck if I didn't. He's a drummer boy. He's just a kid. Guts and a sergeant. There's something about him. He's really a good kid.
You're gonna make a wonderful father someday. Billy?
It doesn't make sense anymore. Supposed to be all honor and glory. But But in the battle, I found myself in the middle of hell, and before I knew it, there was Charles on his horse. It's like a dream. Before I knew it, he was gone. Was I supposed to kill him? Who is the enemy? It's a question I can't answer anymore.
I love you, Billy.
I don't want to go back, Brett. But I have to. After all the killing at Gettysburg, both armies will be licking their wounds. It's time for me to get back before the next engagement.
You're not leaving Billy Hazard without something better than army hardtack for the trail. Why, Lieutenant Hazard. Have I the dishonor of addressing a Union deserter? Or is it a Confederate? Either way, you'll be dead soon enough. Isn't that the customary way of disposing of military trash?
Ashton.
Perhaps each side will execute you. Now, that might be amusing.
Don't you think it's time we made our peace?
There's a Confederate camp down the road. And I'm sure that Colonel Randolph and his militia will take pleasure in punishing a deserter.
Ashton!
Get off the horse. Get out of my way, Brett! Get off the horse! Get over there. You gotta leave now.
I love you, Brett Hazard. Never forget that.
Frustrated woman, Ashton. And I know that you tried to have Billy killed because you couldn't have him.
Oh, Brad, don't be ridiculous.
I won't let you do anything more to hurt my husband. Now you're gonna stay right here until Billy is long gone. I do hope you have a safe trip, Ashton. Maybe you could stop at that Confederate camp and charm the colonel into giving you an escort and all.
And if I never see you again, little sister, it would be too soon.
Thank you.
These men have been in this wagon all night. Doctor, they're not supposed to be left here unattended. No, 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 don't take him into the surgical tent. Amputees have priority. Take him into one of the other tents. There's too much vinegar. The proportions are important if it's to have any medicinal effect. And the next time, I want you to make that like I told you. You get back here!
Mrs. Grady.
I want that man discharged. This is not the first time that he's defied me.
Maybe it's the way you treat him. We have to make do with less desirable sorts. But I'll give him a warning.
He'd give them in slop if he could get away with it. I want you to get rid of him.
Need I remind you that I'm the administrator and such decisions are my province?
I just want the best possible treatment for our wounded.
Including the Southern soldiers?
What do you mean?
I appreciate your dedication, Mrs. Grady. But sometimes it seems one-sided.
Mrs. Neal.
But I didn't come to talk to you about that. It's Dr. Crawford. He feels you don't show proper respect when you address him.
I would show him proper respect if he would do the same for his patients. But he treats them like slaughtered animals. And he drinks the whiskey that's intended to ease their pain when we run out of morphine.
We are desperately short of surgeons. And under these conditions...
And he kills more than he saves.
I don't want your insubordination reported to Miss Dix. You're too good a nurse, Mrs. Grady. You put the patients first, and that's admirable. But you must watch your manner. Our position here is difficult enough. I only say this for your own good.
I appreciate your advice, Mrs. Neal. However, you being an administrator can't always know what's right in an emergency.
You didn't even hear what I said. You'll do as I suggest. Please tend to the new arrivals. And don't give morphine again, unless a doctor expressly orders it.
Mrs. Neal, you don't need to worry about running short of morphine. A new shipment arrived this morning. To the generosity of my friend, Congressman Green.
Far too long, Madeline. But you're as lovely as ever.
Thank you, Mr. Colby.
You used to call me Uncle Miles when you were a little girl. There, now that's the smile I remember. I heard you got married again. I'm sorry I couldn't be at the wedding.
I've left my husband.
Oh, I'm very sorry to hear that.
I'm staying at a small boarding house near St. Michael's.
Well, but your own house on the Battery, that hasn't been opened since your father's death. You could live there.
No. For personal reasons, I don't want anyone to know where I am.
I see.
I need to talk to you about Papa's estate. I know he was not a wealthy man when he died.
Run of poor investments, I'm afraid. But then, of course, there's your late husband's money.
I don't want anything that belonged to Justin.
Well, your father's estate alone will be enough to provide you with a small income, and I'll make the arrangements.
Thank you, Uncle Miles. But there's one other thing. When enough time has gone by, my husband can divorce me. For desertion. That is his right. I want you to give me your word that until that time, you won't tell anyone that I'm here in Charleston. Promise me.
You're my client, madam. You're my client. Any information is privileged. But I do wish you'd reconsider. You know, if there was real love.
It's impossible. I can never go back to my husband.